Microsoft Teams Desktop, the new calendar is rolling out, and this is actually a great update. I'm currently in what is considered the old calendar. If you notice over here, I've got day, work week, week, and agenda, but I don't have month view. This is one big issue. To turn on the new calendar when you have this feature, go click on calendar on the sidebar, and then here is new calendar. Select new calendar. It immediately changes. Outlook doesn't close and reopen. I'm going to move to the next week. Here are my appointments. First of all, what different views do we have? I just mentioned we didn't have month view in the old one. Well, we do in the new one. Here is month view. I'm going to go back to work week. Also, the new calendar is using basically Outlook on the web's calendar or modern calendar. That is why I've already set up three time zones over here. I'm in Atlanta. There is Central Time for Chicago, and then there is London. You can have as many time zones as you want. Back over here, looking at all my appointments and events, that is when you would come up here and do a filter. I don't want to see any appointments. I just turned those off. I'm going to turn them back on. Appointments are items that are just for you. You're not meeting with anyone else. So as an example, I need to work on the budget. I'm not meeting with anyone for that. So when I turn that off, it disappears. Turn it back on. Same thing, meetings. Meetings are with someone. It doesn't matter whether it's in person or virtual. Those are your meetings. You can continue to filter by meetings. So as an example, I just want to see meetings. I don't want to see meetings that I'm the organizer. So I could turn those off. And if you're an attendee, you have these options down here. Great feature there. We can also, for the recurrence, if you notice, up at 8:30 on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, I have a Copilot update meeting. So filter, recurrence. I just want to see series. That is all I'm seeing. And then I'm going to go the other way and see just single. Perfect there. Meetings that are in person, that is an option also. You can pick to show all these options here. These should be familiar from Outlook. One item I've noticed, there's two minor issues that I have with this new calendar, and I've reported both of them to Microsoft. Here's one. If I go to filter and I hit categories, there are categories right over here. So if I just want to see, as an example, red category, that is all I can see. Well, I need to rename that red category to training. Well, you can't do it here on this Outlook calendar. So let me pop over to Outlook on the web. I am in Outlook on the web. Also, new Outlook is the same. Now, if you notice, same calendar I had in Teams. But if I go and right-click on this, and I point to categories, here is where you can manage categories. This is what is missing from the Teams calendar. I'm just letting you know in case you want to change this. So if I hit manage, I can always add more. And if I wanted to rename the red category, I would just edit and change that to training as an example. The other item that is missing that I've noticed is this. I'm going to show it to you right now. I'm still on Outlook on the web. If I come over here, I'll just do what I normally do. I'm going to right click, do a new event. I can add a title. I can add attendees. If you notice, Teams meeting is not the default, but in the old Teams calendar, it was always a Teams meeting. But I have this set up, and I'm going to hide this email address that you're seeing. I typed in Carol Wilson. I typed in test, but you notice I've got to go and select Teams meeting right here. I want most of my meetings are Teams meetings, so I'm going to close this. And here's the feature that you have in Outlook Web, but you don't have in Teams calendar. I'm going to go up to the top right to settings. I'm going to go to calendar and go to events and invitations. Right here, add online meetings to all meetings, and it says Microsoft Teams, and I'm going to hit save, close. Now, when I go back to my calendar, right-click and do a new event, you still say, Chris, it's not working. You got to type in somebody's name. And once again, I'm hiding the emails. It immediately becomes a Teams meeting. What is happening over back in Teams, right-click, new event. Same as before, hiding the emails. I've noticed that Teams meeting is not getting turned on here. So just be careful if you're using this calendar in Teams that when you go and schedule something, you make sure if it's a Teams meeting, you have to manually check this, but in Outlook on the web, I don't. I have reported that to Microsoft. We'll see what they do with that. This just recently rolled out, so I will give them that. Almost everything else is working great, except for managing categories and the automatic Teams meeting. You also have this Meet Now feature, which is great. You see that's in chat too. I've got these options here. You may or may not have all of these options, depending on your account, what you have set up. Another great feature is when you're in this calendar is if you want to turn it off and go back to the old one, just turn it off. You don't want to give any feedback, just hit skip. And now you're in the old one, so you don't have to sit there and close Teams and reopen Teams. And I'm going to pop back into the new one real quick, and it just launches that easy. Huge fan of this right now. One last item, if you do want to add more time zones, I'm going to go to More Options, go to your calendar settings, and you can do this in Outlook on the web or over here. And then I'm on the view right here. Here's where you add time zones. It doesn't matter whether you add the time zones here or on Outlook on the web calendar, they do stay in sync. Thank you for your time. My online training classes are listed down below, including my Teams online training. Have a wonderful day.